Hello everyone and welcome to today's video. We've got some really exciting news to share with you that you can probably see behind me. We've bought ourselves a 2014 long wheelbase Mercedes Sprinter and we're going to show you around it. So if you're new to the channel, I'm Bea, my partner Theo is behind the camera. We've been living an alternative lifestyle for 4 years now. We first started off in our VW T4 camper van that we traveled around Europe in before coming back to the UK and buying a narrowboat that we've been living on since then. Just at the end of last year, we bought a plot of land in Portugal with a barn on it that we plan to convert, hopefully at the end of this year. But first, we've got this long wheelbase Sprinter that we're going to be converting. It's a completely new project to us. We've never done anything like this before, and we're really excited to bring you guys along with us.
Wish that I could stay. Wish for this moment to never go away. But it's all in my mind. Though I know that there is nothing to find.
So welcome to the inside of our Sprinter van. As Bea mentioned, it's a long wheelbase, 2014. It's got 70,000 miles on the clock, so it's barely worn in. And yeah, we're just super excited because we've always wanted a Sprinter van. We've seen them out on our travels and they always look super classy, super good vans. And we're just excited to do a self-build project because it's our first one yet. So the inside of the van, as you can see, it's got all this ply lining. Obviously, that's all going to come out, but we can reuse this wood. We're all about reusing as much materials as we can. So this wood here will be reused for maybe things like the bottom of drawers, bottom of cupboards, that kind of thing. It's just thin ply. So we're excited to see what's behind there as well. Hopefully, it's in good condition. I'm sure it is. On the floor, we've got lots of cardboard. That's just for laying out, building templates and that kind of thing. We were just came in the van on one of our live streams and we just kind of marked out with this blue tape, and it's a really good way of getting an idea of how the layout will go. That's one thing, actually, we will be live streaming the whole process pretty much. So in our workshop that we've managed to secure, we're just going to plug the phone in, leave it going, and we're going to live stream as much as we can at the build. So if you haven't got the notification bell ticked or clicked, then you won't get notified when our videos are coming out. So if you're not subscribed, go and subscribe, but make sure everyone who is subscribed to click that notification bell, because you'll be first to know when a new build video is coming out and a new live stream as well. So that's the best way to follow what we're doing. Also, we've obviously got other social media platforms like Instagram, where we'll be doing Insta stories of up-to-date stuff, and Patreon as well. Patreon is a very good way to keep up-to-date, real-time of what we're doing, and you get loads of extras over there as well. So thanks to all of our Patreons. Right, onto the build. So obviously we use this blue tape here, really useful. And this is our bed section. So we're gonna have a nice double bed. It's gonna be about this height, which leaves us, once it's all cladded, insulated, it's gonna leave us a nice little bedroom area, lots of room, and it's nice and high up so that we can have a huge garage underneath. We really enjoyed Helen and Jelly's van. It's the green Sprinter van that we filmed a tour of. Everyone loved it and we did too. They had their bikes underneath here, loads of storage. So this place here in the garage area will be really useful to us. So over here, we're not gonna have a full width bed because there's no need. We've got plenty of space. This van's fairly wide. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna have a shelving unit up the side of the bed so we can put our pants and our socks and all that kind of stuff that you need to store away. So that'll be really useful. One of the other things that we're thinking possibly is to put our fridge here, but we just need to get the measurements back of the fridge that we're going to get. And that's going to be quite exciting because I've never really seen anyone do that before, but maybe that's for a good reason. Maybe the fridge won't go there. It might not fit. It might just be a bit weird. A lot of people have a problem with the fridge being so close to the bedroom because it buzzes and hums. That's not a problem for us. We can literally sleep through anything. I think when you've wild camped for like 4 years, you just learn any little noises outside doesn't really bother us. So yeah, it's fine. Okay, moving on. Over here, we're gonna have a nice big L-shaped seating area. And this is really exciting for us because one of the main things we want in this build is we want a really nice seating area, a really comfortable place. When you've been driving, let's say you've done 300 to 500 miles in a day, the last thing I want to be doing is spinning around some swivel seats and sitting on the exact same chair that you've been sitting on all day. So we're not going to have swivel seats. We're actually going to have a kitchen on the bulkhead, but we'll come to that in a minute. But yeah, we're making this seating area nice and wide so that it's really comfortable. A lot of people make the mistake of building their seating area either too high, so their legs are like almost dangling, and also too narrow. So that's a common mistake. Loads of people we spoke to have done that. But what we want to do is make it really comfortable. So we'll probably repurpose some sort of caravan cushions or something like that. They're probably the comfiest cushions we've ever sat on. So we'll probably do something like that and make it a really nice space to enjoy. So at the front of the van, you can see there's a big metal bulkhead. Obviously, that is going to be removed. We do not need that at all. We want the light to flood through from the windscreen as well. So we're going to remove that, and that's just a couple of bolts, so that should come out very easily, and you'll probably see that in the next video. Our kitchen is going to be on the bulkhead, and you can see how we've tapered it away towards the end of the kitchen to save space so that it's easy to get in and out of the side door. So obviously the kitchen we are excited about because it's a space that you spend a lot of time in, and also we can stand up. That's one of the huge benefits of this, and we need to be really careful because I'm about 6'2", 6'3" nearly. So we need to make sure that when we insulate the top and the floor, that we don't do it too much that I can't stand up anymore. But I'll only be able to stand up in this area anyway. So as long as this part here is high enough for me to stand up, then that's absolutely fine by me. So we also picked up a really cool jampan that is going to be our sink for the kitchen. So that's going to be a really interesting video as well about how we turn that into our sink. And like I said before, we want to repurpose as much stuff as we can. We're all about reusing stuff. We don't want to just buy everything brand new. So that's going to be really interesting to see how it unfolds. And we're pretty certain that this van is going to be really lovely when it's finished. We hope so anyway. It's going to be really comfortable. It needs to be comfortable because this is going to be our full-time home when we've finished it. We are going to be moving into this full-time. And yeah, we're excited to be back in a van full-time. We've been living on a boat and between the van, like a 50-50 mix. But now we're going to be back in the van full-time. So yeah, lots of van life videos to come. So many more adventures, and also, like B said at the start of this video, we've got our barn conversion coming up after this project. So one project at a time, but this channel is about to get very, very exciting. So stay tuned, and we'll see you on the next video.
Head over to theindieproducts.com/shop and check out our new merchandise. Join us on Patreon for exclusive content, and don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification button so you never miss a video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next video. And you can't put up a fight in the misty light.